For the day 3 slab plate project, this video is specifically looking at the sgraffito option of the two. So this is the finished design of my mandala after the sgraffito. This is a side view where the edges are cleaned up to take care of the blue. Now if you don't want to do just one color and scratch it out, you can do kind of an ombre effect, and then later you can change the color of the lines. So you're going to need either underglaze or colored slip, one or two paint brushes, you're probably going to want a metal rib, and some type of loop tool, and maybe even a pencil. And obviously your project at leather hard and cleaned up form. These are just the options of what the black slip looks like and the different color underglazes. These are where you find them for the underglaze. You need 3 coats of those. You can mix them if you want. And then this is the option for the black slip. So here's where some of the soft bristle brushes are if you want to do like the whole plate one color. Otherwise, there are some smaller brushes and some palettes if you want to pour on a little bit of color and mix up for like the ombre. Now, if you're using the black slip, if you want to do your whole plate in black slip, you do want to take a whisk, and those are found over by the soft brushes, and you want to mix it up to kind of pancake consistency. If you're using underglaze, make sure you shake it up with the cover tight. If you do have some paper, pick that off, and then you're just painting on either the slip or the underglaze. Now, underglaze, you do need to do 3 coats and let it dry in between and try to go different directions and use a nice soft brush. If you're using slip, 1 to 2 coats is fine. If you get a little impatient, you can use the blow dryer or the heat gun, just carefully don't over dry. And then you want to make sure you take your brush, put soap in your hand, wash it out, dry it off, and always put back bristles up and wash your whisk and put that back as well. If you used any of the other smaller brushes or palette, make sure you wash those. Try not to waste underglaze, it is expensive. Then you're going to scrape the sides so that way they're nice and clean, so you don't have any rough areas. Double check underneath that you didn't get any underglaze underneath. You do not need to put underglaze or slip underneath. You can put glaze there. Then you're just simply taking a loop tool and you're just following your impression lines from transferring, and you are just scratching out. Now I always like to do a couple different widths. These are going to be more of my defined lines that have a little bit wider mark. You can, of course, use an even wider tool if you want an even more wide line mark. I do eventually go back with a pencil to add some of those fine lines like I kind of show here, just to kind of add a little contrast. That doesn't pull out the material as well with these finer lines, but I do go back in with the brush and kind of brush off some of the little burrs that come up when I pull it. Also remember, do not lean on your plate. You can still dent it. I'm just kind of brushing off some of those burrs, adding some more. And there's the finished sgraffito plate. Have fun!